Hello, lovers. I'm Coach Kara. So today we are here with another relationship video. And according to the title, we are talking about my partner cheated and has a baby on the way, or something to that effect. So I know this is going to be a very serious topic if you have experienced this or may think that you are in this situation and you're just not quite certain. Regardless if your partner is male, female, or other, okay, what else? We're going to talk about the problems and the outcomes and the situations that you may encounter during this process if you decide to stay. Okay? So first of all, let me just say this. With you finding yourself in this sort of compromising situation, love is going to be there, all right? You're going to want to find yourself staying for your person, and that is simply okay. But what you must realize and know is that you're in for, I wouldn't say a feat, but you're in for a very long-term reoccurring situation. So this isn't just something that your partner can do and it just goes away, eventually you forget about it. No, we're talking about a situation that is going to linger for 18 plus years. So upon discovery and proof, you must then determine if you're going to stay. If not, goodbye. But just know, if you're going to stay, just expect to encounter a lot. Mentally, emotionally, physically, and financially. Okay, so the three topics that I want to start with first. Okay, so you find out your person has cheated. All right, let's talk about your relationship. What the aspect of it was, were you in good standings when this occurred or not? Okay, was your person cheating because of just being careless and impulsive, vindictive, whorish? Whatever the case may be, you need to find out why your person did that, because that is going to be indicative of their behavior going forward. If it was just something simply as being irresponsible and reckless, a drunken night at a party, club, whatever, with friends, meet someone, opportunity presents itself, and they do that, that's not good, because that opportunity could present itself again in the future. You just don't know when. Or was it a more petty type move, you know? Are they that type of vindictive personality to where they want to get you back and hurt you or impact the relationship in such a way? You really need to find out the cause of why this occurred. And for how long? Was it emotional or was it just sexual? A one-night stand? You need to know all of the whys if you're going to plan on staying in the situation. You may be in limbo of what to do, but you still need to ask a lot of questions. You also need to ask yourself, will you be able to trust, forgive? You can't forget it. It's ever present, you know, for a very long time, as I stated. So there's a lot of things that you're going to have to consider as far as your relationship goes if you want to sustain it. Now, if you're not going to trust your person, and this isn't the first occurrence, this occurrence is different. Okay, this is a different scenario. So you have a lot going on as far as your emotions go and what your person, or who your person is wanting to be with, that also matters. So you just basically need to find out where your person's heart and mind is, where their head is, basically, and where they want to be. Okay? That's going to be quite challenging in the midst of it all. You're sitting in the middle of a storm, okay? So you have to find a way to step out of it for a minute and really ponder on this sort of scenario, because the dynamic has now changed. Speaking of the third party, okay, is this an individual who may have just realized that they were messing with someone who was in a committed relationship, hell, maybe even married, depending on your circumstance? You're gonna have to meet this person and have a face-to-face, like adults, like a grown person talk. Put your anger aside, because right now you're going to need answers, okay? You're going to want to get all of the tea, every aspect of what is going on between your person and this third party. Hopefully this is the individual who may say, I apologize, I wasn't aware your guy or girl was involved. I didn't know. I wouldn't have done this. I'm so sorry. Unfortunately, here we are. Okay, hopefully this is that type of person who made a mistake and was unaware and doesn't want any more to do with your person. That is the best outcome you can get, because more so than likely, they will be willing to cooperate going forward as far as parenting goes. Okay, on the flip side of things, what if this individual is not cooperative? Maybe they actually have feels for your person, or they want to be devious. They want to impact your relationship in the worst way. Okay, there's that. Or hell, not even be present at all when it comes to the parenting. Speaking of parenting, I would implore you all to have some paternity testing completed, because you want to be certain that this person is being honest when they come back and say, hey, I'm pregnant. Okay? You really want to know that, because if they're not in a committed relationship already, maybe they are. That's even more messy. I'm not going to even go there. Either way, you still need to be certain that the child is yours or your partner's, for several reasons. Okay, responsibility, parenting, and financially. Okay, all of that is going to have to be determined. This is why I say it is going to be quite imperative for you guys to have multiple discussions together if you're planning on staying with your person, or maybe a court to you I'm talking to. A lot of dialogue, like responsibly. And if you are with or have a third party who is being combative, you may have to go a court route. You understand? Again, this situation can become very, very messy, especially when it comes to the parenting of the child. There's going to be a lot of going back and forth. If you have a problematic third party, there's the financial part, the financial aspect. So if you happen to be married or considering marriage with your person, be very careful about that, because in some states, if something was to happen to the parent, just say, just like the father goes to prison or may not be among us on this planet any longer, who is going to be liable for those child support payments? The other spouse. Yeah. So you really want to look into all of that stuff. And again, you are going to have to be financially prepared for this. Even if you're not married, it's going to change your life in such a way. Because today, those little babies are not cheap. They're not inexpensive at all. Okay? Then there's daycare. Are you going to be willing to care for that child if your partner gets sick? Now you have to work and find daycare. If the third party isn't available, what if they get sick? Are you going to be willing to take in the baby or the child? It's going to be a lot, okay? And it is very messy. If this is a situation that you don't have to apply yourself to, then look, I mean, it's not that much love in the world, okay? You can't be that loyal to where you're willing to put yourself through that, because I know of these sorts of situations just as a relationship coach. And for the most part, when it comes to your mental health, your well-being, it doesn't really go well. Okay, so you're going to have to be a very strong-minded person, strong-willed, to be able to sustain in this sort of scenario, this threesome, okay? You know, the one thing that is going to probably hit the worst is, am I going to be, you know, sufficient with my partner? Are we going to be able to sustain and get back? Because what you have to be cognizant of is that usually when someone is found guilty, they're caught, they're at their best, okay? It is the aftermath when things began to calm down, everything's out, you guys have found a routine as far as, you know, whatever. When the child comes, are they going to revert? Are they going to, you know, become stressed out, need an outlet? Whatever the case is, just know that, you know, forget walking on eggshells. You're going to always feel like you're walking on broken glass, because you don't know, neither does your partner know, if this could ever occur. You know, the dynamic may change once again with this third party. Perhaps they may become a little bit more, I don't know, willing to cooperate. Oh, I'm going to just drop the baby off. Or no, you can drop the baby off over here, whatever. Might try to come on to your person. You know, it can get really messy. Especially when someone is trying to be devious. Especially if you know of the third party. That's when it becomes worse. Oh gosh, that's like the worst thing ever. When you know who the other person is. Because you may have a lot of problems. And yeah. So, look. If you're going to stay, the only thing that I can say that would be the best thing to come about this is if you two were not planning on having any children, or maybe you cannot have children, this may be a great opportunity to take on some kind of parenting skills, take a parenting class, you know, become very, very much involved with this child, because that's what it's all going to matter, and who's going to matter at the end of it all, okay? It's this child's well-being. Having people around that's going to care about it, and take care of it. So that would be a really good thing in this aspect. However, if you don't have any children, or neither does your partner, and you're actually planning on having your children or a child, and then this thing happens, it kind of make it not special anymore. You know, it could really put a damper on having a first child. It can kind of ruin things, you know? Yeah, I can go into many different scenarios of how this can really get messy, because there really isn't a bright side to this. The only thing that could really go well is if the third party is willing to cooperate, they are mature in some way, and just willing to be a good parent, be fair. And then your person being cooperative and loyal, faithful, honest, and practicing those good habits. Well, then yes, everything could possibly work out. But just know there's going to be a lot of ups and downs, especially financially, emotionally. Then there's time. Having a child, especially a small one, can be very time consuming. Even for both parents, and it's tiresome. So are you going to be willing to take on that level of responsibility for your person, knowing that they may have to go to work? Both of you do, and is your week to keep that child? Are you really going to be willing to give up your, you know, your personal quality time with your partner to help raise their child? Okay, So there's a lot of things that needs to be, a lot of layers here that are going to have to be pulled back and addressed. It's like there isn't any avoiding it, because avoiding it will create the worst train wreck ever. All right. And anger isn't going to solve it. Fighting, none of that. It only worsens the situation. So this is going to be a situation for a very mature people, to say the least, if you want the better outcome. Otherwise, it can be very, very messy. Drama, baby mama, daddy drama, all of those things that you hear about, yes, they are likely to occur. Oh, yeah. Okay? So, there's not a whole lot of advice I can give towards this sort of situation, because most situations are unique and have their own little, you know, whatever, but I just wanted to paint a picture for you guys. Yeah. So you can see what that will be like. You know, another issue that I thought about when I was brainstorming this is, please tell your partner to use protection. Like, even if they think that they're going to slip up, just have it on them so this doesn't occur. You know, and then that's another thing. You may want to get tested. All of you are going to have to get tested. There's that. Okay? That's like one of the main things. Your health. Because your person did not care about not only theirs, but, you know, everyone else's as well. So there's a lot of things that you're going to have to think about. I would suggest, if you were planning on marrying this person and being with them for, you know, a very long time, for long term, definitely sit down and talk to someone. Go find a counselor or a therapist, because eventually both of you, if not all of you, are going to need this. It could be very mentally stressful. It's going to be draining emotionally. You may not know how you're feeling, may have displaced emotions. There's going to be a lot of mood swings, a lot of regrets, resentments. So you're definitely going to need to talk to someone who is certified, okay? Not mom. You can vent, but to seek advice and to try to act on that, no, you definitely want to speak to a professional to get through this outcome. And you may want to continuously see them if you can afford it, okay? So yes, that is the best advice I can give for you if you are in this sort of situation. Again, it won't be easy, but at the same time, you're going to have to try to make it work just for the betterment of everybody. All right? Yeah. So if you need further relationship coaching, all of my information will be down below. I will be glad to assist you through this sort of ordeal, as I have for quite a few. You know, it's challenging, but having someone in your corner to listen to and to, you know, just to listen, express your feels to, is very, very important. Okay? Yeah. All right, my lovers, I thank you so much for joining me always. That is all for now. Until next time.